Who will wear what on the red carpet? Who will make the first real verbal gaffe during an acceptance speech? What are the chances Neil Patrick Harris will make someone in the audience feel uncomfortable during the opening act? And most important, who's really voting for these films in the first place? We have issues with the Academy Awards, and we are about to dig into the answers with the managing editor of TheDish.com. That's Dish with two H's. Former senior editor at People and who lives and breathes the Hollywood scene. We feel sorry for him sometimes for that. David Kaplan joins us on the show. Hi, David.
Hey there, good afternoon.
This is interesting because all of a sudden you're in the last few days before the Oscars. We now see bombarded in the Hollywood Reporter and many of the other tomes out west the fact that maids are voting for Best Picture sometimes, that the Academy voters don't even see all the films. They basically just check the boxes on who they like. And also one Academy voter who didn't want to be named saying there is no art to Selma, Boyhood. They're all uneven. This is all the wonderful stuff that makes this up, but I got to tell you, don't we know that there's a little truth in all of this?
Yeah, I think, you know, the whole voting procedure for the Oscars, which is made up, obviously, you know, the voters, their Academy members, it's very polarizing. You know, interestingly enough, you know, a few months ago, you know, there was reports coming out that, you know, the people who actually vote for the Oscars, they're not really representative of the films they're producing. They tend to skew a little bit older. You know, they tend to be, you know, more white, which sort of, so there's a lot of backlash, but then again, we do see films that have diversity. And again, you know, it really comes down to maybe which studio has the most money to essentially do this campaign. You know, we've seen a lot of the trades like Variety, like the Hollywood Reporter, movie studios going out spending millions of dollars, those ads that'll say, you know, for your consideration. So sometimes it's the movie with the biggest, you know, budget that can do it. But then I got to say, on the flip side, the Academy, they like their artsy movies. They like their movies with messages. It's very politicized. So at the same time, the best movie doesn't always win.
All right, now let's talk about that politization, if you will, of the Oscars and the movies. American Sniper, a war movie. No matter how you slice it, it is about war. It is more, though, about a man and his fight to come home and how he deals with all of this. Hollywood liberals are very famously against war. They don't like it. They're anti-war. And I'm beginning to hear from some friends of mine out west that there might be some sort of a little idea, if you will. Wait, did we lose him?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. All right. I don't know what happened. I think I started talking about Hollywood liberals and somebody then touched your computer and they shoved it off to the side. They were trying to sabotage us. But there's a thinking process that American Sniper might not win because that Hollywood left does not want to see a war movie become a big deal, a bigger deal than it already is. Do you buy that?
Yeah, I got to tell you, right now it's not looking like it's slated to win any awards, definitely not Best Picture.
Any awards. Now, that's stunning to hear because this was a brilliant film.
Yeah, it's pretty surprising because, you know, it was saw, obviously, by a lot of people. It did well at the box office. But, you know, putting it up against other movies, I mean, really, if you look at anyone's predictions and really, you know, across the political spectrum, across all sorts of critics and publications, it's never named as a movie that would going to be, you know, that would win any awards, whether it's Bradley Cooper for Best Actor, whether it's, of course, you know, for Best Picture. And I think, you know, the reasons are is A, it's a very political movie, which is polarizing. It's being controversial, obviously mainly on the left, and that's a problem. Also, it's a very sort of, you know, like American movie. And keep in mind, the Academy, they like to appeal to a bit of a broad audience. There are international, you know, elements to it. So they're not always fond of sort of embracing these very rah-rah American type of movies. And again, they also like to steer away from controversial movies. And we know this movie's been controversial. People have said it wasn't fact-checked properly. People were nitpicking, you know, that the baby Bradley Cooper's holding in the movie was a doll.
But isn't that ridiculous nitpicking, though? Because let's face it, this is not a documentary, and every movie out there that's based on anything that really happened has all sorts of inaccuracies, just right through. Saving Private Ryan had a tremendous amount of inaccuracies for a war film, yet it was still talked about as one of the best ever.
Yeah, it was definitely, you know, it was really interesting. And I just bring up this aspect of Bradley Cooper holding a fake baby because there were honestly many sort of op-ed pieces written about this, how the movie was fake, sort of focusing on this one point. And if you're going to criticize anything about American Sniper, the fact that a movie uses props is the least of the concerns. You know, I feel if you want to sort of attack or critique the movie, then fine. You know, focus on if there's any historical inaccuracies. That's more of a legitimate concern, whether or not they're right or not. Not sort of props. I think it sort of was unfairly attacked. I thought Bradley Cooper was great in the film. I think it was a really intense role, we know, for him to get into. And it's a very also, and just from sort of a topical perspective, it's a very current story. You know, while this movie's playing in movie theaters, we're seeing the, you know, the real story and the real trial of the guy who, you know, killed American Sniper in real life in Texas play out. So it's really surprising. But again, I mean, it may pick up an award somewhere, you know, one of those more obscure categories. But right now, from picture, actor, actress, supporting actor, actress, it's not being predicted to win anything, which is hugely surprising.
Yeah, no, that would definitely mean that somebody's got a lot of politicization going on in here, if you will. A couple of minutes left. Real quickly, let's run through a couple of things. Specifically, best actor. A lot of people like Michael Keaton, but we're hearing an awful lot of things now about Eddie Redmayne, who did the turn as Stephen Hawking. What do you think?
Yeah, I think, you know, Eddie Redmayne, he's the one right now who looks like he's going to be winning Best Actor. Michael Keaton was great, but it looks like it's Eddie. The Theory of Everything, though, however, doesn't necessarily mean that's going to win Best Picture. Right now, Birdman looks like a well, and that is the movie with Michael Keaton. He plays an actor who basically attempts for a comeback. He's looking amazing. When you get to Best Actress, everyone is talking about Julianne Moore. She was huge in Still Alice. You know, that's the movie where she plays a woman who has the early onset of Alzheimer's. That's supposed to be, you know, massive. Really quickly, we have Best Supporting Actor. You have J.K. Simmons in Whiplash, a music teacher who just, you know, basically tries to rehabilitate kids. And I think he's an amazing actor because I remember him when he was on, like, that HBO series Oz. So to go from sort of this, like, prison inmate to this, you know, Oscar-nominated winning, I think is just so amazing for his career. But those are really the movies, I got to tell you. It's like Boyhood and other movies are just a typical coming-of-age story. Everyone's saying that's also going to pick up award, but I feel those coming-of-age stories, they actually get a little bit tired after a while. I feel like every couple of years, we're like, oh my gosh, there's this great coming-of-age story, but there's only so many times someone can come of age.
You get tired after a while. It just becomes you just get tired of hearing about all the political sides that are going on in here in Hollywood just to do this. If they don't give it to American Sniper, it's an absolute shame. But full disclosure, I have not seen Birdman, so I have to say that. Let's point out to everybody once again, the website is thedish.com, and it's D-I-S-H-H, it's a double H.com. That's where David Kaplan writes. David, thanks so much for stopping in. Let's do this a little more often here, and we can catch up on some of the idiocy that sometimes is La La Land.
Absolutely. Sounds like a plan.
All right. Thanks, David. Take care. Enjoy the show. All right. A shocking announcement from Walmart, and some people are not shocked at all with what Rudy Giuliani said. Let's head for the Friday water cooler right after the break and get into this and so much more, because quite frankly, we need to just kind of like take a breath, let it out. That's what we're going to do when we come back. Oh, the political punching bag is later too, right here on Midpoint.